Hello, wealthy family, and welcome to today's Mindset Monday video. Thank you so much for coming and sharing some time with me. Today, I want to talk about how to use your mind to send telepathic messages. And I want to do this because some people may say, you know, yeah, I hear that we're spiritual beings. Yeah, I know we're powerful. Yeah, we can do this. Sure, manifestation. But they don't really believe this. So I'm going to give you all a method, a trick that I use to prove to myself and allow myself to rewrite my subconscious mind of what's possible and of what's not possible. Okay, so sorry about that. First things first, this only works if you are still in communication with the person. Okay. If you are in an argument with the person or they've passed, it doesn't work as strong. Not saying that you can't send them a message, but it may not work as quickly, okay? But this method is proven to have a call, a text, something, a poke, whatever, from this person within 72 hours, okay? It just shows you how quickly your mind allows you to manifest things. How quickly do things come to you? Because sometimes people are like, oh, manifestation doesn't work. Law of attraction doesn't work. The universal laws don't work. Law of correspondence, that doesn't work. Because I ask for things and it doesn't come to me, right? But I need you to understand that the way how things come to you, the way how the universe responds to you is based off your vibration. It's based off your energy. It's based off your feeling, okay? So if you're saying something and then immediately doubting, you're pushing it away further and further, okay? So know that the universe never denies us anything. It's you solely. It's solely your mind that's stopping you from achieving the things that you want to achieve. And that's why I said this method allowed me to rewrite or reprogram my subconscious mind to say, no, this is possible. No, I can have these things. No, I can do this, okay? So how to send a telepathic message first. Think of the person that you want to contact you, okay? You want to think of a very fond memory, and you want to be still, okay? So let me back up. First, you want to be still. You want to be in a state where you can be focused and not distracted for at least 90 seconds, okay? 3 minutes. A minute and a half to 3 minutes, okay? So be somewhere where it's quiet. You can be focused. You can shut everything down. Secondly, think of this person and think of the most fondest memory you have, whatever good time it may be. It doesn't matter if it's a good time you had yesterday or a good time that you had 10 years ago, okay? This worked for me, for someone who I hadn't spoken to in about 2 years, but we were still friends. Like, we spoke and communicated on social media, but I wanted them to call me or text me. And I was like, let me see if I can get them to do that personal touch, okay? So just to give an example, I had seen that person, it had been about 2 years since we last engaged. So think of a fond memory. Think of, you know, the happiest time that you and this person shared. And allow yourself to really feel it and relive that moment, okay? Let it vividly play out in your mind and hold it for at least 90 seconds. Hold that feeling and hold that vibration, that person's face, their name, that happy occasion that you had with them. Hold it for at least 90 seconds, okay? And as you hold it and you feel it and you really think of the happiness that you had as you were fellowshipping with this person, hanging out with this person, really think of how joyful it would be if they were to call you or text you, okay? So after you hold that moment, that memory of them for at least 90 seconds, then just think, you know, it would be great if this person texts me or sends me a phone call or a DM or whatever, okay? And then you let it go. After that exercise, you let it go and you don't think about it anymore, okay? Don't harness on it. Just do like how you do Amazon. You place your order and know that it's coming. So you know it's coming to you. Don't keep checking on it and saying, where is it, where is it, where is it, where is this person, okay? So you let it go. And within 72 hours, if you are in good states with this person, they'll reach out to you. They'll be like, hey, how you doing? I was just thinking about you. When I first did this, it took the person about a day and a half to contact me. But now I think of someone and they call me within like 30 seconds. So it's great. Or if I'm thinking of someone, I know they're thinking of me and they may shoot me a text and say, hey, you know, yesterday I thought about you. I just didn't have the time to reach out, right? So I know that my vibration is higher, right? And I want you all to do this. And when you do this, come back and comment on this video. Let me know how it turned out for you. But I want you all to do this because right now we're in a time where you need to realize your spiritual powers inside of you. Okay, I've been talking about it, the energy that's coming all through the eclipse, the winter solstice that's coming, all of this beautiful energy that's happening. It's time for us to start tapping more into our spiritual body and allowing your mind and your subconscious to say, hey, you know what? This really does work. I just did this little simple exercise and I brought this to me. I never thought it could happen, but here it is. Boom. Right? With complete confidence, it's going to allow you now to tap more within, because now's the time to do that. Now it's time for us to tap within and stop externalizing our power and the things that's happening outside of us. It's time to let that go. So hopefully this exercise brings a little clarity to you. Like I said, come back and let me know. I know this is a short video, but I want you all to go out and practice this now. Go practice it now, today. And then comment below and let me know, you know, how long did it take the person to reach out to you? Like I said, with my experience, when I first did it, it took about a day and a half. But now it's like, it's quick, right? So I love you all, wealthy family. Please continue to hold yourself in high regard and high esteem. Know that you can accomplish all things and that all things happen through you first. It originates through you first. If you do not have a thought or a desire to accomplish something, it will not come to you. If you don't first think to say, I'm going to get up and go to work, you're not going to get there. Okay? So know that the motivation, that the power that you're looking for starts within you first. Okay? And then if you choose to attribute anything else outside of you, that's fine. But you first, because you are powerful. You are magnificent. And you are a creator of your own reality and circumstance. Okay, wealthy family, I love you all. Continue to stay alert, stay aware, and live in love. Peace.